All right, here we are, here we go. I'm going to try and not do that, actually. I don't know why I did that. I was going to try my whole plan, literally right before I started recording, I was like, yeah, I'm just going to come in with a little bit slow, right? We're going to slow it down. It's a nice Friday morning. For people who are listening to it on the morning times, the morning schedule, I was going to slow it down, like just kind of easy into the morning. But I don't know, I just came out just kicking, just swinging. I didn't mean to do that, but I hope that, you know, give you a little bit of a pep in your step. But welcome back. Feels good to be back. Feels good to have you here. Episode 2 of Full Circus. It's the first sign of consistency. You know, it's the second episode. The first one doesn't count. This is more of a, you know, bring it back. Dependability, reliability. It's these things we can kind of come together and belong as a team. But yeah, it really does. It feels good to be back here with you guys, or not with you, I guess, in a way. But you know, you're with me in spirit, and that's kind of all that counts. It's a beautiful day, beautiful weather. If you like depressing skies, it's so gray. It's so just dark and moody and stormy out. I actually tried dashing, you know, door dashing, delivering food, that kind of business. If you pick up on my slang, a little bit early in the morning, and it was +$3 because it was so dangerous out, right? The weather was bad. The freaking traffic lights went out. Okay. So every quarter mile is a four-way stop. So everything's just packed up, just back and forth, which is, you know, not great for efficiency or safety. And the roads are slippery. And then the freaking brakes start to go out in the car. I'm like, all right, well, maybe this isn't such a good idea, but it's what you got to do. And I start taking back roads because my whole thing is, you know, getting there on time, getting there early, right? If you get food, I've never ordered from DoorDash or anything. And I don't mean to judge you people, but you know, I just feel like that's a waste of money in a way, because it's just, yeah. Is that bad to say for someone, like, I'm getting paid by these people? Like, yeah, don't do that. Like, some of these people order, like, from, it's like right around the corner from a couple places. Like, they like you could walk there. You can see the restaurant from where they live. And I don't mean to judge you guys and say you're lazy or you waste your money, but I guess that's just kind of how it is. That's kind of what I got to say. And I don't mean to dish DoorDash to say, but I guess that's the whole thing, right? You rely on people's inability or their lack of desire to get up. And that's kind of where you profit. And I like it and I appreciate it, but I have no idea. So if you do see my name, if that's how it works, you know you'll get your food real fast, okay? Because I'll do whatever it takes. I'm efficient. I'm super efficient. Always. But man, that is... I don't know. So it was +$3 for every order. I don't know if it's +3 more if you have to pay. I seriously don't know how it works. I have no idea. Interesting, but it's cool. It's cool. It's fine. Point is, give me them 5 stars, baby, because I'm bringing you that food fast. I got tricks. I got tips, all right? I got back roads. I got routes. I got rules of the road, all right? All kinds of secrets. Now, I don't know what's happening. Here's one. I'll give you one. I don't want to give you too many secrets because then, you know, if everybody starts knowing it, then I'm going to be slowed down again. I'm going to have to recreate my rule book. But one of my things, and I don't know if my area is just bad with accidents and people are just, you know, clumsy or there's crime or whatever's going on, but there seems to be a lot of ambulances around, a lot of car chases and stuff. So it's always, you know, part the Red Sea, everybody pulls off to the right side of the road, right? And that's all well and good, and that's cool for those 5 seconds, it might slow you down, but my whole trick is that as soon as they pass, you just whip right back out in the traffic, and you start drafting off the policeman or whatever, you know, and you're just cruising at like 45, and no matter where we are, we just keep vroom, and we just go. And so as soon as you get back, and what are they going to do, pull you over as they're trying to get to wherever they're going to need to be? Nah! No! So it's great. It's been just awesome. So you can get so far. It's kind of like getting a police escort in a way, but for your food. So anyone who's ordering from Panera Bread, just know, okay, you're going to get them bagels. You're going to get them bagels real fast. I show up there 10 minutes early and you're like, what? I didn't even set the table. I don't know why you would set the table for a bagel. Freaking. Okay, it doesn't matter. The point is, I'm super fast with it, and that's an efficient way to get around. If you're living in a bad area, that's how you get around quick, all the time. Just drift right off. Vroom. You won't see a single red light. I'm telling you, for real. All right, every freaking traffic sign will be greener than a monk's mood ring. okay? And that just means calm, like in peace. I don't know. I don't like explaining jokes a lot, but a lot of people don't do mood ring humor these days. But I'm a classic, okay? I like throwing it back. A little mood ring humor never hurt nobody. But that's a good way to get around another one of my tricks, okay? So if you're... you're going to have to close your eyes and really stick with me, okay? You're going to have to picture this hard. Let me get a sip of water. Oh, yeah. It lubricates the vocal cords perfectly. Okay, so anyways, picture this. You're at an opposing stop sign. You're coming up on an opposing stop sign. No. Scratch that. So there's no stop signs. So you're going straight, and it's a four-way intersection. Okay, back roads. And you want to go left. Okay, you want to go left, but there's a guy in front of you who also wants to go left. That's all fine and good. You know, you guys can both go left at the same time. No interference. But he's got like, he's there before you and he sees you coming. He's not going to make that turn because he thinks you're going straight. You don't turn your blinker on. So then he thinks you're going straight. So he doesn't make that turn. And he's got like six cars behind him. So if you just put your blinker on, he's going to make that turn, like, no problem, because he knows where you're going. So then you got to wait for all this traffic. So instead, you don't turn your blinker on till like, the last second, and then you bang, and now you just skip a whole extra 15 seconds. You're welcome. I probably shouldn't have said that. Again, I don't want to share these rules of the road, because now I feel like I'm going to get screwed. Can we go back, please? Seriously, maybe that was a bad idea. I don't know. Time will tell. Is it any wonder I've got too much time on my hands? No, I cut it off, but that's what I had to do. Hey, welcome back to the show. That song wasn't as long as the first one in the first episode. I don't know, so it doesn't really feel like we took a break. Little intermission for some DJ raps. Maybe that's my new thing. It's just putting in some random music and then cutting it off right before the good part. And I sing over it. Or maybe I'll do karaoke. I have no idea, you know. Like I said, time will tell. And just like the traffic things, it's true. I've just got too much time on my hands to come up with some random crap, right? Just a bunch of load of stuff that doesn't really matter, but it does, in a way. It makes a difference. Sometimes the smallest things are... You know how we kind of work our way through life, okay? What's been going on? Yesterday was St. Patrick's Day, or 2 days ago, Friday, right? You're welcome. St. Patrick's Day, I didn't really do anything for that. I think it's mostly just a day for people who like to pinch each other. And, you know, nobody pinched me. I didn't have anybody to pinch, but I didn't wear green. And I don't know if that bodes well for luck, but I did it. You know who does go all out for St. Patrick's Day? There's some lady, she's not like super close, but she's in the world of, you know, area. And she decorates her house for like every holiday you could come up with, right? St. Patrick's Day, she's got leprechauns, she's got four-leaf clovers, the whole shebang, right? Lucky charms, top of the morning to you laddies. And I'm just like, you know, how, like, what holidays does she not have? Because if you got stuff for St. Patrick's Day, and I don't mean to be offending to the Irish folk, especially not doing an Irish accent, but, you know, it's fine. It's not like the biggest holiday in the world, right? But she's got freaking decorations for it. She's got decorations. She's got stuff for Groundhog Day, right? You could see Punxsutawney Phil, like freaking inflatables. I didn't even know they made those. And I don't know why my voice keeps cracking. I feel like I'm getting sick or something. I have no idea. But it is definitely not the luck of the Irish. Maybe I should have worn green. Maybe that's the curse. And I don't even know about it. Yeah, anyway, so she's just got all these freaking decorations, right? First you go Christmas, you're like, okay, obviously, that's awesome. Then you go Halloween, like, all right, that's understandable. It's kind of cool. That's cool. Not a lot of people do it, but that's cool. Thanksgiving, you're like, okay, well, it's weird to have a turkey and stuff out. And then you're like Easter, and you're like, well, I haven't seen that often. You know, it's still a big holiday, but it's you don't see decorations for Easter often. And then you start going Valentine's Day, Groundhog Day, Earth Day. Like, there can't be anything else in that house besides decorations at this point, right? Like, I swear to you, it's just a warehouse. If you went and knocked on the door, you would open it and be like, they would just get washed out with random crap. There's not a holiday you could think up that she doesn't have. She's got you beat, I guarantee you. There's nothing you could say, ever. I mean, I guess the point of that is there's way too many holidays to begin with, right? You could look up any day and it'd be like, oh, you know, look up, put your cup on the counter day or ice cream for breakfast day. And I don't mean to say that's not a good idea. That's cool and all. But there's just way too many. Why are there so many holidays? Why are they like holiday? Holiday? You're going to tell me there's a holiday for everything? For ice cream for breakfast? I know someone's probably out there. It's like, you have no idea. You have no idea how much ice cream for breakfast made a difference in my life. Hey, my grandma died to have that holiday established on the calendar. Screw you for saying it's not real, man. And that's sad. And I apologize to that guy. And I didn't know he's gonna get so emotional. But I guess on the other hand, maybe his grandma would still be here if she wasn't having ice cream for breakfast. sorry, grandma. Sorry to these fictional people I just made up. Yeah. So, anyways, I don't know what the deal with that is, but there's so many holidays, and I get it can be cool to an extent. Like if you just want a reason to talk about anything, right? There's National Handstand Day, there's National, you know, put your trash away, which you should be doing anyways. But just literally anything, I would just try it. Just think of anything on Google and think of it. Waffle, any food, especially with a bit, like in America, you know, we love our food, and you could just think of any food, and you'd be like, oh yeah, it's just. We got the holiday for that. Oh, crepes? Yeah. Orange juice? Yeah. It's just anything. And that lady's got the decorations for it. So, you know, and even if that guy feels bad about his grandma, at least he can drive past that house and see ice cream for breakfast day. And she's got that. And I don't know why, but that she has it. I guarantee you. So anyways, what is going on besides that? Oh, those traffic lights. The traffic lights are out, dude. It's been horrible. It's been horrible. Do you know how, like, backed up traffic gets going slow down, especially once you get, like, closer into, the morning hours with all the school zones and crap? And why do you gotta slow down in a school zone, dude? Right after a freaking four-way stop with 18 other cars all congested and crap, and then you slow down, and that's just making more... What? And slowing down in a school zone, I get it. You know, it's kind of cool about the safety, but, like, that's kind of... it's kind of predator mentality if you think about it. We're going to slow down once we get near children? Seems kind of weird, man. I know what you're saying. Yeah, right. It's for the safety of the children. But what about their mentality? Right? I've been a kid. It's been scary stuff. So I make sure I always speed up in school zones all the time. And when I see kids on the sidewalk, I zoom past them. Because then they know they don't got to fear me. Right? I'm not a kidnapper or anything like that. Because I've been a kid. I've been there. And I was a cute kid, dude. I was a cute kid and I was adorable, still am. But when I was a kid, I was afraid of kidnappers and all kinds of crap like that stuff all the time. Because when cars go slow, and maybe they're just being safe, but that's scary because you hear stories, you hear stuff, right? So when I was younger, when I was in school, we had this thing called the blue truck. The blue truck. You get on school one day, you get on the bus, and everyone's talking about, oh, the blue truck. The blue truck. Did you? I saw a blue truck this morning. I saw a blue truck, too. Everyone's just seeing blue trucks. But story about this guy in a blue truck tried to kidnap some other kid some other time. And now everyone's just freaking out. Everyone's drawing. These people are making drawings with their crayons and stuff like, oh, this is a picture of it. This is what it looks like. If you see it, identify it. Call the cops. And I was like, well, Timmy, your eight-year-old artwork does not qualify for what I need to see. But I will trust it, and I will be scared with you regardless, because like I said, I'm adorable, right? And I don't mean to say that ugly kids aren't targets for, you know, predators and stuff, but, you know, I just have to say, there has to be some level of standard, right? Like the people you see on the back of the milk carton, those might as well be, like, they might as well be in a catalog for Fisher Price, right? These are beautiful, beautiful kids. And I'm a beautiful kid. Still am. Again. But so I was a kid, I was terrified. Because I knew I was like a number one draft pick on these kidnappers' list. I had to be scared and I had to be on my toes all the time. So we had this blue truck. And it was just always, you see it and you just dive, right? Everyone just dives, runs in the bushes. No matter what, you were afraid all the time. Everyone was so scared. I remember one time I was out waiting for the bus this day, right? And I'm out there, the bus is not coming, and I'm alone. And I'm just like at the end of the street, right by my house. So it's not like too scary. But at the same time, it's like, well, you know, I'm not there. I'm only 8 years old or whatever. And I was just scared. I'm just terrified. And I was terrified for like a long time because of all these stories and stuff everyone was spreading. And they were true, I assume. I never looked it up. but for the point of the story, I just assume that they are all true because I still don't know. So vehicles start coming by. And this is why I say speed up, because when the cars were fast, I felt safe. I felt good. I felt like no one was trying to hurt me or get me because I was okay. Like I said, adorable. Still am. So when these cars were going fast and who just didn't have like any courtesy for like children nearby, I was like, yeah, you know, they might be reckless, but at least they're not trying to get me. But when these cars would go slow, dude, I would be scared out of my mind all the time. And all of a sudden you start seeing this truck, right? There's a truck. It's like magenta or something like that. And it's like, it's a pickup truck. Kind of looks like the picture, right? And I know everyone was saying blue truck, but like, I'm not going to risk my life on like these other kids' ability to perceive color. So it's like, if this kind of like, well, maybe someone just doesn't know how to differentiate between blue and purple that well. It's like, well, so this kind of magenta's truck. And besides, if someone's driving a magenta truck, like that's a creeper spirit right there. That's a little freaky. So I run behind this house, this neighbor's house, and I'm hiding in the bushes, ooh, shaking in my boots, and just scared. I was scared all the time. And you never knew. And I don't. And maybe it isn't blue to begin with, to further my point on that, because a lot of people that went to that school, they didn't, you know, they weren't dumb, but they weren't really good with their colors. So anyways, I'm in this bush, right? And these cars, they're all going slow and scared. And I guess the bus came, this is besides the point, but I guess the bus came while I was hiding in this dude's bushes, like behind his house, in his garden or something. And the bus came and it left. And then I was just left alone. Like, now the bus wasn't coming. So now I knew I was alone and the cars were going slow. And that the trucks and stuff literally scared the crap out of me. I ended up going to, like, I had to go, you know, I was on duty. I was safety patrol. And I, you know, I dropped a little bit of that night soil in this guy's garden. And I didn't think about it at the time till later on. It's like, dude, I just natural fertilizer, son. And a poor guy, but, you know, his plants grew well because I had a healthy diet back then. And yeah, it was terrifying, dude. I can't even explain how scared life is for a cute kid. So I always, always speed up. And that's why I think you should speed up in school zone, at least for these adorable kids. And it's kind of like a silver lining, you know, maybe you're not that good looking of a kid or something like that. And maybe you feel bad, but you know, at least you're a little bit safe, right? Like my mom would always call the cops all the time if I got lost, because she knew I was a high target. I was high money, baby. Everyone was looking at me. Still are. but it's just the way that it is. It was scared. She always called the cops if I was out of her sight for like 5 minutes. Boom. Someone came to get him. But if anyone else disappeared, right? Or if once I put on a little bit of weight as a kid, you know, if I walk off, she's like, she's not calling the cops. She's like, yeah, you know. He might be lost, but yeah, he's still here, right? He's still somewhere in the vicinity. Like, he's still in this area because, yeah, no one's going to pick up the fatty. But that's okay. You know, silver lining to everything. And truth be told, I did feel a little bit safer. So, like I said, silver lining. So that's definitely something you want to be safe about. And probably not poop in too many people's gardens just because it's ideal for the other people. So speed up and just watch out for these kids. Like, I mean, like for the mentality, I guess also watch out for them if you're speeding through, but also, and that's one of the things I'm trying to learn about now because I'm 22 and I still feel and act like a kid. And maybe that's not a good thing, but I still kind of have that childlike spirit to me. So I kind of forget that I am an adult, right? As I've been like this size since I was like 13 or 14. So I was like, yeah, you know, I'm still a kid. And I heard people getting kidnapped at 14. It's like, yeah, so I'm still that. And I kind of forget about that sometimes. So I was skateboarding last summer, right? I was skateboarding last summer at this playground. And you got this big mustache on. And, well, I do, not you. So I'm skateboarding, and I don't think anything of it until I start recording myself doing my kickflip attempts. I didn't learn it. Sorry. And I see myself with this mustache, and I'm like, dude, this guy's just hanging out. And all of a sudden, I got this view, and I was like, oh, no. Like, this is the guy, like, I would probably run from if I was a kid. Because mustache is, listen, and this is going to be a hard truth for a lot of you people out here. But I don't think there are a lot of people / anyone who can pull off a mustache without... Okay, well, I guess there's only two choices, right? Unless you're Tom Selleck, you either look like an idiot or a pedophile. Sorry. And that's kind of what I had to see and realize in myself. Everyone's like, no, dude, I swear I could pull off a mustache real good. And look, no, you can't, right? I thought I was that guy too. It wasn't. It's not true. So let's just, I guess your best case scenario is hope that you are the idiot in the room. Okay. You look like a fool, and that's okay. As long as you don't look like a creep. Right. So that was just something I didn't want to embrace, and I didn't want to embody, and I didn't want to scare these kids, because it's just like, oh, I'm a friendly guy, and people are walking by like, hey, how you doing? And then it's like, oh, and everyone, they start walking a little faster. I'm like, what's going on? But, yeah, it is what it is. So don't do that, and be mindful. And I'm working on that. Let me get another swig of water real quick. Oh, yeah. Lubricates the vocal cords. So nice. Yeah. What else has been going on? The stimulus money, right? The stimulus money from the government. How amazing is that? Just freaking $1,400 show up right in your bank account. Just a regular morning. Like yesterday, I made $1,435 in an hour. Can you believe that? That's nuts. It was fast. It's like, see you later, like acting jobs and stuff I need to do, or this voiceover and freelance stuff I've been doing. Don't need that. Just made $1,400 a day. Top that. Actually, speaking of that freelance stuff, I was going to do some freelance voiceover. Again, I was doing some stuff, and then all of a sudden, because I made some money, I tried to withdraw my money through that account, and they were like, "Yeah, you can't do that because you need to be verified." And I had made this account probably 2 years ago, so like, yeah, we're gonna call you, we're gonna FaceTime you, and we're just gonna kind of talk and make sure it's you. And one, I don't like I've like. My photo, like, I've got this big freaking bushy, you know, luxurious facial rug going on. And so I don't even look kind of like that is. And I got this hat and it's everything. I just don't even look like the guy in the photo. I barely do. So that anyways, they call me. I'm starting to get a little nervous because, like, dang, we're going to try and verify you. Just make sure you are who you are. I'm like, well, how hard can it be, right? How hard can it be? It's still me. Still me. They're gonna be able to pick up on that. So all of a sudden they start asking questions, right? Start asking for what? Then not like asking me direct questions, but questions about my account, which I again hadn't made in like 2 years. Like, what's like your personal goal thing that you set on your profile? And I'm like, I don't know. I mean, I know voiceover is included, but I think there's, I'm like, yeah, okay. I'm like, why? Your tone sounds very dismissive of what I'm saying here. I was getting a little nervous, and they start asking me. Then a couple clients that I did, or was I the client? I don't even know how that works. But for a couple of jobs that I was doing voiceover before for, again, a while back, and they're like, oh, so what was that for? And I was like, it was just like a little ad for like. Some like facial pen or something like that. Like, either like, yeah, okay. And what was the client's name? Like, what was the business? Like, I don't know. And it was just, I was getting so nervous. I was getting scared. I was like, man, I'm starting to, like, hearing myself, like, I don't even know, you know? Like, can I even trust? Am I me? You're starting to make me question whether I'm even myself at this point. So they're getting me on my toes. I'm sweating and pouring, like, which nothing looks more deceiving than a guy sweating when you're just asking him, like, what his goals are on freelance. So I'm like, okay, yeah, we're almost there. All right, sir, we're almost there. Just put it together. I'm like, yeah, okay, I got you. So what else do you want to know? And long story short, I failed every question. But for some reason, somehow, I guess they were just like, all right, well, I guess that's you. I guess it's you. It's like, wait, what? It's like, well, how? I mean, your step process, like, is horrible. One, because I failed everything, and you're still gonna tell me. But I was like, yes, I'm valid. And there's nothing, you know, validation is like, you know, great and affirmation, telling people you're something and you're all great and whatever. And I just wanted to be validated as me. I didn't even need to be like, I didn't need validation as like some awesome guy in freelance or voiceover or whatever. I just, like, at this point, I was so lost. I was like, I just at least tell me I'm me. At least tell me I'm me and I'll be okay. But so it worked out in the end. Turns out I am me and it worked out great. So that's how that ended. So thank you, people at freelance. You're awesome. So anyways, thank you guys so much. This has been episode 2. It kind of went by fast. I don't even know what I talked about besides running from blue trucks and stuff. But I hope it was well. Hope it worked great. Hope it lifted your spirits just a little bit. I know it's a little bit shorter, but I think 26, 27 minutes is kind of that sweet spot. Am I saying that just because that's where I am? Yes. Now, I'll have to listen back and see if I really slowed down my tone to try and welcome you into the morning, but I doubt I did it. I doubt I was able to put together a coherent sentence. Probably kind of like a Looney Tune, like when they're chasing like flies around. But anyways, thank you guys so much for listening. Hope you guys have an amazing weekend. Kick it off with a smile, baby. And I'll see you guys next week. Dependability, reliability. Two words that you can count on, hopefully. But I will see you guys next week. Thanks so much for listening. Love you. Appreciate you. And I'll see you. Also, I don't know why I'm repeating myself over and over again, but I'm going to say it one more time. Thanks so much. All right, I love you guys. Bye. Is it any wonder I've